The mega earthquake that could destroy Japan by 2050. Under the ocean at a depth of 4,500 meters hides a structure that silently threatens to destroy much of Japan before 2050. This is the Nankai Trench, a geological formation that has historically produced the deadliest earthquakes in Japan's history. The government of Japan has predicted that a mega earthquake of magnitude 9 or higher will occur in this place in the next 30 years, which could claim more than 300,000 lives if the necessary forecasts are not made. But how do they know that the next mega earthquake will occur here? Which cities are the most vulnerable to this catastrophic event? And how is Japan preparing for this mega earthquake? Prepare yourself. This video will tell you everything you need to know about the Nankai Trench mega earthquake. Why is this area so prone to earthquakes? Japan is known for being one of the most seismically active countries in the world, and this is no coincidence. The Japanese archipelago is located within one of the planet's most complex and dynamic tectonic zones, the Pacific Ring of Fire. This ring is a substantial geological chain that borders the Pacific Ocean and extends along the coasts of America, Asia, and Oceania. Approximately 90% of all earthquakes in the world occur within this region, and Japan is at the heart of the system. The Ring of Fire results from the interaction of multiple tectonic plates colliding, sliding, or overlapping each other. Japan in particular is located at the convergence of four major tectonic plates: the Pacific Plate, the Philippine Plate, the Eurasian Plate, and the North American Plate. This collision of the four plates generates a massive accumulation of energy along the subduction zones, where one plate sinks under another, causing deformations and ruptures in the Earth's crust. Within this region is the Nankai Trench, a subduction zone in southern Japan's Philippine Sea. It extends roughly from Suruga Bay in Shizuoka Prefecture to the southern coast of Kyushu Island, passing in front of Shikoku and the Kii Peninsula Islands. Its formation results from the tectonic process where the Philippine Plate subducts, slides downwards under the Eurasian Plate, accumulating an enormous amount of tectonic energy. The trench has a maximum depth of around 4,500 meters, making it shallower than other ocean trenches, but extremely seismically active. It is one of the key regions for the formation of mega earthquakes, since the friction between the plates generates an accumulation of tension that, when released, causes violent earthquakes and catastrophic tsunamis. The nearest islands are Shikoku, Honshu, especially the Kii Peninsula, and parts of Kyushu. Due to its proximity to densely populated areas and its ability to generate large tsunamis, the Nankai Trench is one of the most significant seismic risks in Japan and the world. From a geological point of view, the constant movement of tectonic plates in the region where the Nankai Trench is located makes the occurrence of future large earthquakes inevitable. In this context, the next Nankai Trench mega earthquake is a scientific certainty, although its exact date is still impossible to predict. The historical pattern and current measurements indicate that the region is entering a new seismic cycle. This event is so vital for the future of Japan that it has its name in Japanese, Nankai Torafu Kyodai Jishin, which means the Nankai Trench mega earthquake. The largest earthquakes in the Nankai Trench. Japan's history is marked by a series of significant earthquakes that have shaped its geography and culture, and it focuses on seismic prevention and preparedness. Some of the most devastating earthquakes associated with or near the Nankai Trench are: Number 1, Nankai Earthquake of 1707, magnitude estimated between 8.6 and 8.7. This earthquake caused a massive tsunami that devastated the southern coast of Japan, especially in Shikoku and Kii. The tsunami resulted in more than 5,000 deaths and enormous damage to villages and coastal crops. This event is a key reference for estimating what could happen in the future. Number 2. Nankai earthquake of 1854. Magnitude 8.4. This event is part of a seismic cycle known as the Double NC event, consisting of two earthquakes occurring less than 32 hours apart. The consequences of these events were approximately 3,000 people killed, widespread destruction, fires, and a tsunami that devastated large coastal areas. Number 3. 1946 Nankai earthquake, magnitude 8.1. This mainly affected the Shikoku and Kii regions. It caused more than 1,300 deaths and severe damage to port infrastructure, buildings, and rural areas. Number 4. Tokai earthquake of 1854, magnitude 8.4. Although it didn't happen directly in the Nankai Trench, it did happen in the neighboring Tokai area, showing how interconnected faults can activate multiple seismic segments. This earthquake caused enormous destruction in nearby cities and more than 10,000 deaths. It was one of the deadliest earthquakes in history. Number 5. 2011 Tohoku earthquake, magnitude 9.0. This one did not occur in the Nankai Trench, but it is a recent example of what a subduction earthquake can generate. Being the deadliest in recent history, this earthquake left more than 15,000 dead, the tsunami that caused the Fukushima nuclear disaster had a global economic impact. The historical recurrence of these events is a clear warning that the Nankai Trench has the potential to release catastrophic energy in the near future. Hey, before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can improve them for you, the viewer. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by making sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our daily videos. How scientists know that a mega earthquake is approaching in the Nankai Trench? Scientists have been monitoring this area for decades due to the apparent periodicity of large earthquakes. Since the 17th century, a pattern of cyclical breakups has been documented approximately every 100 to 150 years. The last major event occurred in 1946, meaning that the region has been building up tension for nearly 80 years and is approaching a new cycle of tectonic energy ejection that could be released in the coming years. Dr. Yoshihiro Kaneda, a Japanese geophysicist, has led multiple studies on plate deformation in the Nankai Trench and has analyzed the periodicity with which these earthquakes occur. This underscores the importance of anticipating an imminent mega-earthquake in the next 30 years. On the other hand, researcher Ryota Hino, a seismologist at Tohoku University, has modeled rupture and tsunami scenarios. These have made it possible to estimate that a mega-earthquake in the Nankai Trench would have the capacity to produce a gigantic tsunami that could claim the lives of up to 320,000 people. This geological context makes scientists consider a mega-earthquake inevitable in the coming decades. Areas of higher risk. Some models, such as those of Professor Shinji Toda of Tohoku University, known for his studies on fault segmentation and cascade rupture scenarios, suggests that the next Nankai Trench mega-earthquake could cause significant destruction. GPS monitoring systems and underwater sensors show that the plates are locked, and the cumulative slip is equivalent to an earthquake of magnitude 8.5 or higher, placing it within the category of subduction mega-quakes, similar to the 2011 Tohoku earthquake or the 2004 Sumatra earthquake. This magnitude range implies an event capable of releasing an amount of energy equivalent to the detonation of millions of atomic bombs, with a destructive potential that could surpass any recent natural disaster in Japan. Seismic hazard maps produced by the Japan Meteorological Agency, JMA, the National Institute of Advanced Industrial Science and Technology, AIST, and other research centers identify the following areas as high-risk hotspots: Shikoku coastal prefectures, Kii regions, Tokai coast, densely populated cities such as Nagoya and Osaka, urban areas of Tokyo, especially the Tokyo Bay areas, due to soil liquefaction and amplification of seismic waves in soft terrain. In addition to the direct devastation caused by the earthquake, the tsunami waves generated by the mega earthquake were one of the main threats. Dr. Koshun Yamaoka from Nagoya University, specialized in modeling seismic wave propagation and evaluating seismic damage and tsunami in the Tokai and Nankai region, and has carried out different simulation models. These have helped estimate that tsunami waves could exceed 20 meters in height, penetrating several kilometers inland. This poses an extreme danger to critical infrastructure, nuclear power plants, commercial ports, and coastal communities that, despite having defenses, were not designed to withstand events of this magnitude. How Japan is preparing for the Nankai Trench mega earthquake. The most likely scenario for the next Nankai Trench mega earthquake begins with a sudden slip along the subduction zone, where the Philippine plate slides sharply under the Eurasian plate after decades of stress buildup. This sudden release of energy will generate primary and secondary seismic waves, which will travel through the Earth's crust and reach coastal cities in seconds. In coastal areas, the ground is likely to sink or rise several meters. Fortunately, Japan has an early warning system that detects the first waves and sends automatic messages to phones, trains, and factories. This system could give 10 to 30 seconds of warning before the most destructive waves. 30 seconds may not seem like much, but it can be the difference between being on the 10th floor of a building or the first floor before the earthquake starts. 5 to 10 minutes after the earthquake, tsunami waves are expected to begin hitting the Shikoku, Kii, and Tokai coasts. At some points, water is expected to penetrate up to 5 kilometers inland. Japan is a world leader in seismic disaster preparedness. In the face of the imminent catastrophe of a mega earthquake in the coming decades, the government of Japan has implemented different strategies. Early warning systems are integrated into televisions, radios, and mobile phones, and are activated simultaneously when an earthquake is detected. Anti-seismic infrastructure, such as buildings and bridges in critical areas, have been reinforced to withstand extreme earthquakes. Every year on September 1st, Disaster Prevention Day, millions participate in drills inspired by scenarios such as the Nankai Trench. Global impact of the Nankai Trench mega earthquake. A mega earthquake of this magnitude will affect Japan and have global repercussions. Let us remember that Japan is a key node in the global production of technology, automobiles, and electronic components. A natural disaster in Japan will affect the supply of different technologies worldwide. Not to mention that Japan is the world's third largest economy. If it were to suffer billions in losses, it could trigger a global economic crisis. We must not also forget that although Japan would be mainly affected by the earthquake, the resulting tsunami would travel through the Pacific Ocean and affect all the countries that have coasts in that ocean, such as South Korea, Taiwan, the Philippines, Hawaii, Mexico, and all of Central and South America. The Nankai Trench is one of the most dangerous seismic zones in the world, and the next mega earthquake could occur there. Although it is not possible to predict exactly how or when it will occur, science has determined that it could occur within the next 30 years and have a magnitude of up to 9. This makes it extremely dangerous due to its ability to create a tsunami that could claim the lives of hundreds of thousands of people. Japan's government is preparing for this inevitable event, but will it be enough? Let us know what you think in the comments.